Hey guys, Adi Yeshaya here. After a nice, overwhelming responses I received from you for the first episode of Arranging Tips, I'm ready and excited to present to you the second episode. The topic this time is background writing. I will break down the subject to a number of categories and present to you this time just the first one, which is single note backgrounds. Although the rhythm section plays an important part of the background, it won't be part of the discussion today. We will discuss the middle ground layer that lies between the melody and the basics of the rhythm. So before we jump in, I'd like to highlight a couple very important guidelines regarding background writing. The first one, the purpose for writing a background part is to complement the melody and highlight it. The background part could be exciting, it could be playful, but it should not obstruct the melody and it should not step on it. The second one, strive to create some kind of contrast with your backgrounds. Contrast could be accomplished in a variety of ways. It could be a timbre, it could be the dynamics, it could be the amount of activity, it could be the register, the type of instruments, and long list of possibilities. So, let's dive in. The term guide tones is normally associated with one or two stepwise, smooth moving lines in a chord progression. When combined with the bass, they paint a much fuller harmonic picture in the background. Guide tones are used as light background parts to a melodic line or an improvised solo. They are usually the third and the seventh of the chord, although this concept may be extended into other notes. Guide tones work best over progressions with bass movement in intervals of fifths or fourths. That includes diminished fifth or augmented fourth. Here, the third and the seventh alternate when chords are changing. Let's take a look. The following line will be taken through a few stages in use of this method. Example A will show the basic concept with long notes, smooth, voice-led movement. Here is the use of guide tones in fragments. Each fragment is self-contained, and the space between the fragments creates a lighter vibe. Guide tone connections can be made simultaneously in two levels of 3 to 7 and 7 to 3 resolutions. Notice that when a skip occurs over the same chord, the interruption in stepwise motion is irrelevant. Now let's add some simple melodic embellishments. Here are three examples of guide tones in the background. The first example is of the most basic concept, with a simple melodic embellishment in the fourth bar.
Remember, you vowed by all the stars above you. Remember.
The next example will show additional chord functions added to the guide tone concept.
People stare, it looked so romantic, but darling, I swear, I was telling him about you. You passed by and caught my eye. You
Now here's an example that combines two layers of guide tones. The saxes in typical alternating 3 and 7s. The trumpets are playing additional note choices. Notice how the trumpet's line loosely marks the melody notes, which is a common technique in arranging for vocalists. Also, notice in this segment how the intervallic distance between both parts helps to establish a transparent tone.
And there's a brave new star-spangled sky above you. When you're in love, you're a hero. A Nero, Apollo, the Wizard of Oz.
A common note is a sustained single note over a progression of changing chords. This is a similar concept to the pedal point, but it's typically placed in the upper register above the melody. The sustained note keeps shifting its harmonic function with a variety of chord tones or tensions as the chords below keep changing. Here's an example of applying this technique in the background of an improvised solo. And now over a melody.
Black is sky, so stars can shine. Tiger stripes and butterflies.
A directional line is a stepwise climb using chord tones, tensions, and occasional diatonic approach notes. The rhythm is flexible and does not need to stay consistent. Before looking at recorded examples, let's create a chord progression and compose two possibilities for a directional line over it. Now, let's check some examples. A riff is a repeated musical statement that is usually played in the background of a melody or an improvised solo. Here are some examples. The first one is very simple and sparse. It's played by two trumpets and two trombones as call and response. The minor second interval, which emphasizes the blue note effect, is possible because it's played by two instruments of each kind. The next example is more active and rhythmic.
So I'll get the last laugh. I'll be parading high fives on the way out of here and pay it right back. My best laid plans ceremony.
The third example uses two riffs against each other as call and response. The last example for this category can easily be defined as fills, much like what a horn player would play behind a singer.
You're disguised, the black and cloak where there ain't no lace, there ain't no white, but I can see your face. So when I think it's time that you fade.
Lastly, we're going to look at the secondary composed melody to accompany or complement the main melodic line. Often we'll refer to it loosely as counterpoint, but if so, think about it more as a freestyle counterpoint secondary to the main melody. All right, everyone, this concludes the first part of our subject. Stay tuned to the next episode of Arranging Tips. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and help spreading the word. Thank you so much for watching.